Chit Baba Batra, page 58. We are four lines from the top of the page. Important disclaimer today. As we learn Agadeta, we learn the part that it's kind of stories. The Maharal Ben Yehoyada and others warn us not to take the text literally. So we try to explain our very best, but we should remember that there is a absolutely another level of understanding these stories. We start with the story of Rabbi Bana'a. Bana'a, it's like from the Hebrew word binyan, the Yun Yaakov said that it's Bonetziu Nei Rabbanan. He was the one who go to those grave sites. In the ancient time they used to have a cave, like Cave of Machpelah and other caves, and he measured them to make sure that people who are Kohanim or others who have issue of ritual impurity will not contact the framework, the area that prohibited those area that we are not allowed to touch the corpse or the part of the deceased. So Rabbi Bana'a hava kametzayen me'arta. He used to go to those cave and mark them. The Rashbam said, and I quote, Adam gadol v'chashuv haya. Rabbi Bana'a was very important, not ordinary but extraordinary rabbi. Lefichach nitan lo reshut leikanes bekivrei tzadikim. So therefore he granted a special permission to enter the gravesite of the righteous. Aval acher lo kedamrinan, as we learn in Tractate Chulin, page 7b, gdolim tzadikim bemitatan yoter mibechayehen. So Rabbi Bana'a has a special zchut, above average, that he was allowed to enter the gravesite of the righteous, but he has a special goal. He wanted to make sure that he marked it properly, and people can pray there, people be careful in certain areas. The Hasidic Rebbe, the Rabbi of Shiniva, he said that we have a derivative from this story. There are people who are lenient when it's come to Meiron in North Israel, visiting the gravesite of righteous. But he brought, you see it also in the Avnei Nezer, in Bnei Yisachar and other, that said that when it's come to the Cave of Machpelah, excluding the head of Esav, the rest, obviously, it's a place that carry sanctity. However, one should be careful if he is a Kohen. Ki matan l'im'arta de Abraham. So when he entered to the Cave of Abraham, and the Ben Yoyada and others said it was not a physical, it was more in a sense of vision, but anyway, Ashkechei le'Eliezer Eved Abraham. So the you see it in the Masechet Derech Eretz and others, either that was seven or nine exceptionally righteous biblical images that merited not, in our sense, receive a regular death, and they are entered the paradise. But he said, the Ka'ei Kamei Abava, that he was standing there. Amar le Maika Avid Avraham, Amar le Gane Bichnafa de Sarah Bekama Ainai le Bereshe. So, the simple way is that she, Sarah, the wife of Abraham, she looked at his head. But obviously there is several explanations. The Hasidic Rebbe of Heinich of Alexander said that because Eliezer brought a dress to the house of Rivka to show her the way of modesty of Sarah, or others said it's because Sarah unlike Abraham, the husband wife, that he is granted to the poor cash versus the wife that granted food the indigent. So she exceeded his zchuyot. But anyway, Amarlei zil emalei banai karababa, go and tell them that banai entered. Amarlei leol, said that he should enter. Meida yadia deyetzer ba'al maleika. So he knows that it's not a yetzer hara. Nimukei Yosef said that it's not an evil inclination. It's not applied to the world of truth. It's only here in Olam HaDimyon, as Rambam said, the world of imaginations, but not there. So it's not applicable, the issue of a modesty and attachment between him and her. Ayel ayen venafak ki matani marta adam rishon yatzta bat kol amra nistakalta bidbut diukni. So obviously we know that Adam, the first man, was created in the image of the Lord, and therefore they said that it's an issue to look at that image. Obviously there is a lot of midrashic explanations how come his generation merited to see him, but anyway, bidyukni atzma al tistakel, should not look at my so Rabbi Bana said habeina letzayune me'arata, I have a purpose, not here just for another reason, I'm here in order to mark the graves, the measurement of the graves, and more, because the name of Marat HaMachpelah, as you see, it's the cave of Kaful, of double, and as Gmarin Eruvin tells us that it was the gravesite of the four pairs, Adam, Chava, Abraham, Sarah, Yitzchak, Rivka, Yaakov, and Leah. So I have a purpose. I need, Rabbi Manaah said, to mark the graveside of the location, etc. The Gesher HaChaim, Rabbi Tikuchinsky and others said that here we have Re'ayot, we have a proof from our Gemara how exactly one should construct the cemetery. כמידת החיצונה כך מידת הפנימית, the measurement, the voice from heaven said, is equal, the measurement from outside is equal to the inside. ולמאן דאמר שני, כמידת שני בתים זו למעלה מזו, כמידת עליונה כך מידת התחתונה, which means the top is the same as the bottom. The Gemara in Eruvin 51 brings the disputation between Rav and Shmuel how exactly the double of Ma'arat HaMachpola, if it's one at the top of the others or not. But again, as we said, that it's a big disputation when it's come to Kivrei Tzadikim. If one allow, one not allow, you see a Minchat Elazar in chapter 3 and others have a discussion over that. But anyway, Amar Rabbi Bana'a, when I was outside of the graveside of the cave of the first man Adam, nistakalti bishnei akevav vedomim lishnei galgalei chama, I looked at his heels, and he looks and it appeared to me like two wheels of the sun. So obviously, as we said, is kind of anthropomorphic. Hakol bifnei sarah kekov bifnei adam, sarah bifnei chava kekov bifnei adam, chava bifnei adam kekov bifnei adam, adam bifnei shechina kekov bifnei adam. So it's all reflection, as Gemara Pesachim 8 said, of the Almighty. But as we said that in Yigdal, the Rambam tells us, and you see it in all the principle of faith, Ein lo dmut haguf ve'ein no guf. We do not have any image of the Lord by any means. It's all anthropomorphic. It's all human expressions, שופריד רב כהנא, מיין שופריד רבי אבאו, שופריד רבי אבאו, מיין שופריד יעקב אבינו, שופריד יעקב אבינו, מיין שופריד האדם הראשון. So each beauty is a semblance of the beauty of the first one. The Minchat Elazar, the Rebbe of Munkach, he explains that as far as warning, Hatra'a, the first man have Hatra'a from God. And that's the idea of Atchasreu Me'at Me'elokim. But anyway, Haruam Gosha, it was a certain either magician or psychic, Da'av Hatit Shichvei, that he was touching and moving the bodies from the graves and take off the straw. Kimatam arata derav tuvi bar matna, tafsei bedikne, again, literally, you mean to say that the deceased is alive now. But as we said earlier, that many explanation, the Yun Yaakov bring the value of beard, and the concept of understanding from that. But anyway, אמר לי במטותא מן עכשיו קי, leave me please, לשנה אחרית האדר עתה בדקני, אתה ביי לא שבתקי עד איתה מספרה וגזיה לדקני. חתם סופר derived from that, the value of זקן. But anyway, we can go not only in the literal sense, obviously there is way more. ההודה אמר לו, one person was a שכיב מרע, was about to pass, said, to his sons, חווית דאפרה לחד בריי, חווית דגרמי לחד בריי, חווית דאודרה לחי בריי, לא חוו ידעי מה כאמר לו. He said a statement that wasn't clear to his children, how exactly he's about to divide his estate. עתו לקמי דרבי בנאה, so they came before רבי בנאה to understand what he's saying. אמר לו, איתלכו ארעה, do you have any estate that your father left for you? אמרו לי, אין. איתלכו חיוותה. Do you have a animals that the father left? אין. We have איתלו בסתרקי. You have sheets, linens. אין. יחגי כאמר לכו. So it means that he meant to say to those things, to the estate, to the animals, to the linen, etc. The whole concept, as we said, when we come to touching hair, is a well-known response of Nodab Yehuda. We're getting close to Chol HaMoed Pesach. So in Chol HaMoed, as we know, is a rabbinic prohibition of not taking a haircut and not to shave. So Nodab Yehuda said that he said to a certain po'el ani, indigent person, he said, "Letzorech HaMelech Mutar." And he explained and he wrote, "I have Tam HaKamus, I have a concealed explanation." And the Chatam Sofer explains, and he said that since it's a conservative, the hair growth, he used Ta'ar, which is prohibited by biblical law, is better to violate rabbinic and not biblical. But anyway, Ugavra Desham Devitiu de Kamra Livratei, he heard his wife said to his daughter, to their daughter, Amai lot ni'at be'isora, hach iteta asara bnei itlach, ve'leitlach me'avu el achad, only one son I have from the father, ki shachiv amar lo kol nechsai lechad bara, לא ידעי לאי מיניו. So they don't know out of 10 sons which one he inherited the estate. עתו לקמי דרבי בנאה, אמר לו, זילו חבותו כברה דאבוכון, עד דקאי ומגלה לכו לאי מנחו שבקה. Go to the and hit the grave of your father until he tells you which one he inherited the estate. עזל כולהו, so all of them follow the Rabbi Bana'a advice. Ahu divrei lo ava azal, the real son did not do it out of respect for his father. So that's called Shura de Dainei. He felt that his intent is not to inherit his estate to all the sons. Amalu kulu nichsei dehai, it all belongs to him. and there is Aruch Laner, there is Nadav Yehuda, and others try to explain how far you go with that, what exactly allow or not. Is a Chida explains the famous Rashi that said that when Yitzchak was born, Klaster Panav, the Almighty made his face look like his father, based on this Gemara. Anyway, אז לו אכלו קורצאי במלכה, אמרי איקה גברה חד ביהודאיו, וכמה פיק ממונה מנשי בלו סעדו ולו מידי. התיו חבשו, so obviously it was act of paying back from the nine brothers. They inform him and cause him to be arrested. אז לד דוד הוא, the wife went, אמרה להו, the wife of רבי בנאה went, and she said, עבדה חדבה לי, פסקו לרישי ופשטו למשכי, ואכלו בשרי וקמלו במאיה, ומשקו בלחבריה, ולוחי החייב להדמי ולא אגרי, לא ידי מה כאמר לו. The whole purpose she said it, Rabbi said, in order to find an interpreter to explain to those non-Jewish judges what she meant. אמר נעיתו לך כמה יהודי יהודי, ולמה קראו לרבי בנאה, אמרו לו זרנו כאמרה לכו. So basically they brought him and he explained her meaning. And obviously when they understand, then they not only release him but appoint him as a judge. Amrei yoil v'chakim kulei leitev abava v'nidon dina. So let him sit on the gate where the judges a congregant and being one of our judge. So the Maharsha said that it was implications if it's befitting to be judge, etc. Anyway, Chazad Ahava Ktiv Be'abula. So he went and he seed in Abula. Abula meaning the gate, the entrance. So called Dayan the Mitkerel Din Lashmei Dayan. So again, the Maharsha explained that any judge that who's summoned to judgment is not considered a judge because a judge must be above approach. Amar lu ela me'ata ata inish me'alma. If that is so, then if a person comes from elsewhere, meaning, for example, just from the street. Page 58, B, umazmin lei ledina, and summon a judge to a judgment. So they said, psalai hu, so paslei, so he basically disqualified this judge, even if he were later to be exonerated. Ela kol dayan de mitkere ledin umakpin, umapkin minei memona bedin lav shmei dayan. So you have to say that this is judge that is summoned to judgment and money is lawfully taken from him, which means he was ordered to return someone's property, is not considered a judge. When they heard this, they wrote this addendum to the original inscription. מפקין ממני אמונה בדינים לב שמי דיין. חזד הכתיב בראש כל מוטה ענן דם. So בראש כל חיין ענה חמר. So again, literally, it's like the blood and the wine. אלא מעתה, the נפיל באגרה ומית, someone who God forbid fall from the roof and die, would נפיל מדקלה ומית, fall from the palm tree and die, דמקת לי, you mean to say the blood killed him? ותו מן לדרכי למימת משקולי חמרה וחיי. So someone who is about to pass away, you give him wine and he leaves. So it means you can't tell me that the blood and wine control the life and death. אלא אחי בא אלה מכתב, בראש כל מרעין ענה דם, בראש כל הזבן ענה חמר. So it means the head of those medicine is the wine, the head of the sickness is the blood. לחלקת יעקב ותשובה, by the way, if you can, one can take a blood donation from everyone or not. משה רבינו, עליו השלום, refused to לינוק, to nurse. Anyway, כתבו אחי ברמסה וליהודה, יאמרי בראש כל מרין ענה דם, בראש כל הסוון ענה חמר, באתן דילי חמר, תמן מתברו סמנים. כתב הפיתחה דקפוטקיה, אנפק, אנבג, אנטל, that's measurement. וזהו אנטל, זהו רביעית של תורה. So that's basically the אנטל, that it's a quarter log of the Torah. And you see, we're getting close to Pesach, the four cups on Pesach, בהיצה ומחצה, that's the אסמכתה from the Torah. The Mordechai asked, why specifically wine? So maybe he said that that's implied to the Kos Paro with Yosef. Some said אסמכתה is והוצאתי והצלתי וגאלתי ולקחתי, the four לשונות of גאולה. The Shem Mishmuel said that in Egypt, כלל ישראל was like שיקורים, but anyway they serve God, ויאמינו באשר משה עבדו. Anyway, כתבו אחרי ברם סבי דיהודה ימרי בראש כל מרעין, ענן דם בראש כל הסבן, ענך אמר. So that's basically the source of understanding that that's the רביעית. Some say that אנטל, that's the מטבע שתבו חכמים for the washing hand, for נטילת ידיים. Mentioning Pesach, mentioning wine as a side note. Many rabbis say that we are in a different generation. Number four, during the Haggadah, it's important numbers, you know, the four sons, the four kashes. One should remember, the most important thing is the fifth son, that unfortunately we're facing in our generation, those who not even bother to come to the Seder. That's the importance of Seder, that the family, the extended family will get together and strengthen each other and learn more about our past, present and future and how we connected. And part of that is learning Kadesh Urchatz, Kadesh, the Kiddush, the wine, the idea of the wine. It's amazing. It was not long ago in the what is called the Dow Jones the journal, right? So they said there that is the index of kosher wine, with the expert in kosher wine. So reading that, one think, not long ago it was in the code, the Taz, the commentary on the code on Shulchan Aruch, that said that because it's a blood libel so much against us, one should be careful with the red wine, not always can use, etc. All these blood libel from England to Poland to all this Germany, all these terrible things that the European Christians blame us for no reason. So we are so privileged that now, in a generation, we have this Dow Jones in this country, they gave an index of kosher wine. So not only Golden and Medina, but also the obligation to teach V'igadta lebincha, that's the key point in Pesach. Anyway, the Mishnah continue and give us the list of chazakah, of items that can have a presumptive of ownership. Hamarzev, the spout protruding from one's roof gutter, draining water into another's property. אין לו חזקה ויש למקומו חזקה. המזחילה יש לה חזקה. סולם המצרי אין לו חזקה ולצורי יש לו חזקה. חלון המצרית אין לה חזקה ולצורית יש לה חזקה. איזו היא חלון המצרית? כמו שאין ראשו של אדם יכול להיכנס לתוכה. רבי יהודה אומר, אם יש לה מלבן אף על פי שאין ראשו של אדם יכול להיכנס לתוכה, הרי זו חזקה. running out of time. Okay. מאי המרזב אין לו חזקה ויש למקומו חזקה. אמר רב יהודה, אמר רב אחי כאמר, המרזב אין לו חזקה מרוח אחד ויש למקומו חזקה משתי רוחות. רבי חנינה אמר, המרזב אין לו חזקה שאם היה ארוך מקצרו ויש למקומו חזקה, שאם בא לעוקרו אין לו רשאי לעוקרו. Third explanation, רבי ירמיה בר אבא אמר, המרזב אין לו חזקה שאם רוצה לבנות תחתיו בונה ויש למקומו חזקה שאם בא לעוקרו אינו עוקרו. Page 59, תנן המזחילה, this is challenge the third explanation. They said that a gutter pipe יש לה חזקה. בישלמה למאן דאמר הנכתר תשפירא, למאן דאמר שאם רצה לבנות תחתיו בונה מאין הפקלה מיני. זהו ריבש, but anyway, הכה במזחילה של בניין עסקינן, דאמר לו, ניחא לי דתיתרא השיטה. that any time you hit, all my walls are shaken. That's basically a basic question, halacha. If someone leave even his own door that causes others to potentially have the thieves that comes in, how far it's his obligation? There is a book, I'd like to conclude with the responsa in a book called Shara Mishpat, that it dealt with the divorcee. As you know, that garush and grusha lo yaguru b'makom echad, a divorce and divorcee, the rule is that they should not live the same location. Why? So they said chashash, there is a concern, shema yavor lidei chet, they come to the grip of sin. So the question in halacha, it was a case of someone that tried to impose upon his fellow who engaged with a fellow's ex, and he said that you cannot come and live here because that's basically force me to move out of this location. How far you go with these rules? Do you say girei delay, that you indirectly cause a nezek, a damage, or not? Because there is a notion, Shara Mishpat said, that yachol le'akev, that because of that, he may refrain that fellow from relocating his ex to that, the place that he lives at this present moment.